Welcome back to YouTube.com/EvilSqueegeeRar. I am Evil Squeegee. Today I will be your marshal. Today we have Pukajutsu. You can catch him over at twitch.tv/Pukajutsu. He does Final Fantasy XIV stuff and other stuff. And Kajer, who is back again, despite being electrocuted more times than we can count. We have chips. Did Pyromancy fix the chips?
He says that he fixed everything.
All right.
Although
so...
I'm confused as how he motorboated Scrubthulu, because much like Moradin in his infinite dicks, I'm pretty sure that Scrubthulu.
That's gonna make like no sense to anyone. On YouTube
have...
at all.
Where this is going.
Oh, you like it, Pook?
Yeah.
So, I would like everybody who wants to go first. Kajer or Pook, who wants to draw first from the pot?
I can go.
All right. You're going to draw three random?
All right. I've actually found the random button again.
You got a red. You got a red. You got a red? I swear to God, if every chip today is a red from the random button... we're going to bust out the Unnatural Dice while we're talking here. Unnatural Dice, if you are unfamiliar, Unnatural Dice is our way of thanking you guys, the audience, who support the show fiscally. The idea here is, while you're hanging out, if you donate, there's a link, Hypemark Support. It has all of the information that you need to know about what you can purchase. Crits, botches, assists, resists.
I heard you can purchase Chris Botches.
You can target players with good and bad fortune, or just chaos. That's also a thing. And you can buy destiny tokens, which let you do crazy things like picking the backlashes that go down when Chris actually botches his spellcast. Or, you know, what happens to people when they fail a scart check, among other things. So, with that out of the way, you can also shout BEAT, B-E-A-T, in all capitals, all right? If five people shout BEAT in all caps when something funny happens, that player gets a beat. Beats turn into white chips. Those chips are important because they help the players not goddamn die, which is really important.
I would like to not goddamn die.
Botches for them bitches. All right, we're going to botch the bitch.
Botches.
All right, so we have Judas 2 chips. Okay.
I still have to actually update the...
Alright, so, Pook, hit that button.
Hit the random button. I'm hitting the random button.
Did I spell it B-E-E-T? Is that something I actually did?
No, I just think they're fucking...
That's a white chip.
Alright.
It's a white chip. And a white chip.
Nope, it was just me.
Alright, ready? Ah. My turn. My turn is gonna be... I got a...
Blue.
A blue,
a red,
and a white. I am patri-fucking-otic.
Is there an upper limit on white chips that I can have?
Each chip is worth a certain number of points, all right? Whites are one, reds are two, blues are three, greens are five.
Okay.
All right? If you need to help remembering that, it's the order I put them down on the overlay.
Yeah.
White, red, blue, right? You can't have more than 10 points of chips. If you have 10 or more points of chips, whenever you would draw a chip, don't.
Oh.
So if you have 9, then you pull a legend chip, you're packing 14 points of chips, you don't have to get rid of anything, but you can't draw anymore until you drop below 10. All right? Chips can be spent on preventing damage, enhancing rolls. Whites can be spent to add dice to a roll. So let's say you're rolling 3d8, and you get nothing, you can be like, I'm spend a white, roll one more d8. I'm gonna spend a white, roll one more d8. Then you can graduate and spend a blue or a red. Those will take your highest die and force it to explode from where it is, right? So if your highest die was a 5 on a d8, you'd roll a d8 and add 5 and keep going until you stopped exploding there. If you spend a red like that, you need to... you spend it, and then I pull from the pot as the marshal, all right? And then you can also use them to restore wind that you have lost, or prevent wounds. They prevent a number of wounds equal to the points they're worth.
So I was already at 10 before today's draw because I have two whites, a red, and a green.
All right, so spend three whites then. Okay. Your legend chip can be used to reroll any roll, including a botch. If you do that, it is gone forever. You can use it to prevent five wounds to maximum restore all of your wind.
Okay.
At the end of a session, or rather, generally speaking, at the start of a session, you can spend chips for XP. 1, 2, 3, 5.
I always keep one blue for emergencies.
Yep.
Yeah.
Always keeping a blue on yourself for emergencies is good, but like just dumping everything at the start of a session before you draw is also good. In your case, I would probably dump for the 5 XP on the legend chip. Because that'll free you up to have more chips to protect yourself with later.
That's true. I could...
So if you would like to do that, let me know before you draw, or before your draw of three whites.
So, yeah, I'm gonna dump the legend for 5 XP and okay. then just take the three whites.
So you're down to 0 legend, right?
Yeah.
And then you're up to 6 whites?
No, that's going to be 5 whites because I had room.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Did you add the legend back to the pot with the command?
Spend L is the command.
In roll 20.
L. Got it. Spending a legend chip. Yay!
All right, so on a count of 3. 3, 2, 1.
Cognition.
Cognition.
I don't know what it says that after a year, I'm not uncomfortable with that.
Like, you know what it says? It says, the fuck? Because that is what everybody who's watching this show for the first time just said. Alright? So, if you are watching on YouTube, there is going to be a point right now. Here is the dancing for Imagining Mystic. This is where the gameplay starts to happen. Oh, if you're watching on YouTube, we always like, you can skip all the intro and just get straight to the gameplay if you want. Mm-hmm. So that people don't have to sit through like 15 minutes of us fucking around. Doing pre-gameplay stuff.
Yeah.
So, cognition in place. Sam is gonna have to go do other things for the day. It's not uncommon for Sam to have business she does not want to discuss to attend to. So this is going to leave us with our investigations focusing primarily on Matthias and Fletcher. Now, we'll start with the season's recap. As y'all have been tracking the man that never sleeps, you ran into some terrible, terrible fates. Matthias' soul had been sucked into Sam's body, and then freed from it after having met with Matthias' old mentor. Now, Matthias' old mentor had a horse, and this horse has been integral to the party's travels ever since. While y'all were in... Not Dodge City, Salt Lake City. You encountered a young man by the name of Fletcher, who rather introduced himself as Fletcher. Now, unbeknownst to y'all, Fletcher has had some family issues as of late. You see, Fletcher comes from a line of journalists, investigators, and photographers that are well esteemed inside their community. And Fletcher has dreams of working for the Tombstone Epitaph, that is to say, the tabloid that preaches all that nonsense about the supernatural.
Like my trash rags.
Now, the marshal decided that it was a good idea to set himself to do not disturb during the broadcast. And as a result, y'all find yourselves here in Salt Lake City. Technically speaking, you ain't certain where the trail picks up. So it's going to take y'all a bit to find your way through... Mostly the junkyard, because the Mormons ain't having none of you.
Mm-hmm.
There are reports to the authorities of strange folk walking through the streets in them nice picket fence farm houses and so on. And so you are basically ushered to where you belong, the Junkyard. The Junkyard is the nickname for the steampunk district where all the labor, the soot, the smut, and the pipes going through the sky from the great factories of Dr. Darius Hellstrom, basically the inventor of mad science. That supports, he is the fiscal backbone that makes Salt Lake City such a beautiful place to live, unless you're not Mormon. Now, as you've been escorted into the lower areas of the city, it's going to take each of you a little bit of investigating to find out where this man that never sleeps went. You trailed him here, but you don't know where he went after that. So, I'm going to have to ask y'all what you're going to be doing in order to discover the whereabouts of your quarry.
Well, at first I was, because it was the middle of the day, my initial response was to basically, go from, door to door, looking people's windows, trying to locate him. But
are you telling me that you would be liking yourself to be rolling perception to stare inside of strangers' windows in the Junkyard?
Well, I figure, as sneaky as I might be, in the middle of the day, it did not take long for me to have been aggressively removed from the premises.
Correct. And
I feel like by the time this process is finished, it has occurred to me that a camera can't actually owe me money. And so now I'm trying to figure out who actually does owe me money. Because it ain't him and it ain't the camera, but somebody has my money. And so now I'm trying to piece that together.
Guess you're off the hook. Pat the bag.
Maybe the camera can owe me money. So I'm going to, based on our encounter in Minesville, I'm actually going to head to the saloon because it seems like, the man who never sleeps does tend to get the attention of the ladies in particular.
All right. So Matthias proposes that perhaps we investigated the saloon. Fletcher, if you had to find somebody in Salt Lake City, where would you go?
I would absolutely go to a saloon. I would ask at a local watering hole.
You sound like you got a bit of a northeastern accent going on there.
Yeah. I'm sorry. It just happens every once in a while.
That's all right.
Yeah. it's something that the people with money are trying out. They're not
fancy.
That's actually sadly more accurate for the Deadlands universe than it probably should be.
Right.
I definitely would go where all the talk happens, and that would be where people gather.
All right, so you're going to be joining Matthias on this excursion to the watering hole?
Well, as he has decided that he has kidnapped me, I don't know if I have a lot of choice in the matter.
If Sam's not keeping an eye on him, then I gotta.
Yeah, so.
Until I figure out what the fuck happened to my money.
He's got
to
keep basically like all five eyes on you.
Yeah, and I can't imagine going that far to track down some money, but my choices are limited, and I'm going to go along with it.
All right, so Emmy is going to be helping Sam today, so it's just y'all.
I was just about to inquire as far as how Emmy's doing.
Emmy is going to be arguing with her horse and following Sam around as she is wont to do. She seems to be a little bit better. Each passing day, she seems to be regaining a tad bit more strength. But it is curious that you have found some sort of weariness that magic itself cannot cure.
Yeah, and we don't really know how she got it, because she weren't eating.
Nope.
Which is also curious that she weren't eating.
So, y'all head into the saloon. I happen to have a fancy pants saloon place to bring you. Check that out. Been a while since we've brought y'all here, ain't it?
Is this the same one I urinated in?
No.
Alright.
It's not there. It's not there. It ain't there. It's definitely not here.
Oh no. We ain't going there.
Alright, there you go.
Oh.
Matthias remembers this, because this was the first place we ever went. This is where Matthias was kicked in the groin with a spur. I mean, not the specific instance of the saloon, but this map, this graphic, brings back memories. Oh. I have never enjoyed kicking you in the nuts so much in my life, Chris.
I'm pretty sure there ain't an instance where you've not enjoyed kicking me in the nuts when you had the opportunity.
What are friends for? I'm lucky here, all right? I'm not just working with coworkers and collaborating with content creators. I've known, Pook, was it 13 years I've known you?
Yeah.
And Kajer, it feels like it's been 20, but I think it's been more like 8, 9.
Yeah, I think we're going on 8, because I think you guys had known each other for 5 or 6 years when I met you.
Pook and I met in the Maple Story live beta, and then Kajer and I met in the most tragic dungeon run of our World of Warcraft careers.
I like to think of it as majestic,
We definitely redefined the boundaries of what could happen in a dungeon. Yes. However...
Now, Matthias, can I ask you something real quick before we head into this place?
Yeah, sure, what's up?
You seem to have a knack for making a scene. Can I ask that perhaps we play this one a little... low key, I guess they would say.
I will fix my collar and my jacket. And I will say, I will have you know, sir, I am a master of subtlety when it is required.
Right then.
All right, so Matthias, subtlety has been requested. How do you go about subtly collecting information from the patrons at the saloon?
Part of me wants to now figure out the best way that I can make a show of it, but that part of me is not as important as my ego. So, I'm gonna head up to the bar and, you know what? I'm just gonna order me some cheap swill. I still do have $400,
which is a lot of money. You can get, I think you can get a room for a night for 50 cents.
Yeah, so I will. I'm not gonna go for the top shelf because I don't need the attention of everyone. But what I am gonna do is I'm gonna go for some liquor that shows that I have some money to spend.
Matthias has definitely, or Kajer has definitely played at the table with me for a long time. You'll notice one of the primary factors in deciding what he is going to buy is how many people will see how much money I have. And he decides not to attract as much attention to his money as possible because he knows me.
So I will have you know that because I am who I am, each $10 bill is located at a different part of my jacket. I have more or less lined.
He has 40 pockets inside his coat. Hey, can you make change for 30? Yes, I can. Hold on just a moment. Like,
listen, I wrote the script, all right? Oh.
No. You wrote the script. I wrote the script!
All right, so yeah, I'm going to buy me some not quite top-tier liquor, but I'm going to get me...
All right. Strangely, and you're not certain how unsettled you are supposed to be by this just yet, Fletcher. I mean, you only know the man for a few hours. Matthias seems to be acting normal. What do you do?
I say a silent prayer and thanks. And I'm going to join him in this. Because one of the reasons that I want to not draw a lot of attention to myself is because of fear that somebody might recognize me just by reputation.
Right, right. I mean, this is the junkyard, and you are from the nice part of town, so...
Uh-huh.
All right.
Uh-huh. So, I understand that he's not being as inconspicuous as possible, but he's being enough that I might tag along to not draw any further interest to myself.
All right. So, since you are basically trying to shrink inside yourself and not exist, I would like you to roll me a stealth check. Sneaking seems the skill appropriate... I'm sorry, the aptitude appropriate to this task.
All right. So, I am going to need... a little bit of assistance.
Alright, so the number of dice is going to be equal to your sneak and aptitude. The type of die you are rolling is going to be equal to your, in this case, I'ma call it smarts. Because this is a bit of a navigational thing and not like a physical hiding that you're doing.
Right.
So you're going to roll, sneaking D smarts. Now, sneak. When you type this in, you're going to put, slash roll... and then whatever the dice code is, and then you can put two exclamation points at the end of it directly. No spaces before the exclamation points. That will force the roller to automatically force these things to explode. Of all the dice you are rolling, you are only taking the highest result.
Would I be able to make a scrutinize to see what he's doing? To notice him tricking on himself?
Yeah, you roll me scrutinize, and before Pook rolls any dice, we got to double check and see if he has any... unnatural crits.
That's what I was going to bring up. I've got an unnatural crit, but I've also got some, I have a resist before that?
No, you follow the left side first, okay. Always.
Okay.
So, you have a crit, and then I botch. So, this would be Majestic.
You got a crit from Haseosaura?
Curtis.
Haseosaura!
Yeah, I got some support here from Haseosaura, who's, I appreciate that.
I do not approve of you bringing in your community from your stream into my show in order to unbalance the game in your favor. That is abusive, and I do not think that is fair.
I can't buy my own success. What is this?
I believe it's called privilege.
This is...
and I got plenty of it.
well, shit.
somebody clip that. So you are actually so Matthias. You botch and he crits. Here's kind of what happens. All right. So Pook, right? You just happen to have this, or I'm sorry, Fletcher. You seem to have this sense of like when people are looking at you, as so you turn away so that nobody actually sees your face, and you're always like looking around all nonchalant and natural like. Now, you are trying to hide and you crit, and then Matthias is trying to find you and he botches. How easily do you think it would be? How easily do you think you and Kajer could coordinate something for me here? So Chris is looking around. Chris, can you look, raise your left hand for a moment, please? Okay. So when you look to your left, turn your head to your left so that Frank can see which way you need to be looking. All right. So Pook, when Matthias turns and looks in that direction, I need you to just like not be on camera, and then when he looks away, be back, and then not be on camera. All right, and I'll be narrating this as the narrator, and we're going to try and make ourselves an epic moment here, all right? Let's see. This is acting, all right? We all graduated from the school of Jean Picard. Acting, all right? You see what I'm saying?
No, I don't.
That's because I am acting so well that you are putty in my hands. All right, so...
I don't want any of me in your hands.
Right? Okay, so on the count of three. Two.
Hold on, I think Frank...
I'm good.
All right, Frank's get ready. All right, so. Matthias, will you shut up? The narrator is trying to talk.
Oh, okay, that's what that
is. And you're going to be active. Well, okay.
I've already got botches. I don't give a shit about sassing you.
All right. Somebody add quote that. Matthias was a man who had been in many saloons before. It occurred to him that he had walked in this place with a young individual calling himself Fletcher, but he was not certain where Fletcher may have been. Now, he seemed to look this way and that way, but Fletcher was nowhere to be found. Was Fletcher behind him? Was Fletcher above him? Nope, it did not appear to be behind him or above him. That must mean that Fletcher was in front of him.
Oh, money shot.
No, really in front of him. Must have been very, very in front of him. No, maybe Fletcher was underneath him. It was a big billowing black cloak that Matthias had chosen to wear that day, and so he wasn't certain. Maybe he was to the right. Maybe Fletcher was to the right. Nope, Fletcher must be to the left. Fletcher must be to the left. Nope, Fletcher was not to the left either. Where could Fletcher have gone?
Am I the only person that feels like this is a moment out of
the... Back with, like, the hat, like...
Am I the only person that felt like that was a moment from, like, the children's cartoons?
That's exactly what I was going for! Thank you! Bravo. Pook, if you have... I think you have room. You can take a white chip for that beat that was called for you and your privilege. And also, you can line up two motherfucking bosses from Pyromancy who declared that you do not have privilege.
they'll exceed the limit.
What? Wait, do you have 10? A red chip is 3. I'm sorry, a red chip is 2, and you got 5 whites and a red.
Yeah, so it should be 7.
Pyromancy, your damn script is broken again.
It's only because it didn't count him spending the legend chip. Try updating the spreadsheet. Yeah, that's updated.
Yeah. So somebody take a note. Pyromancy's got to come in here and fix things live again. Why do I hire you to do all my code in Pyro? This is shameful. This is shameful.
Probably because you pay him in mac and cheese.
I got something wrong with...
Stop giving away my business secrets!
That's why they're called macro. Because they're paid in macro.
Is the macro right? The macro... Oh, I bet you the macro is fucking wrong. Hold on. Nope! Sorry, I did not actually edit any of the spending into the macros. So what is the spend command? This is why, no matter what he does, it fucks up, because my part of the whole thing is goddamn broken. It's not his fault.
Oh, so it just said spending a legend chip.
Right, it didn't actually spend a chip. I also don't think it actually took a white chip. No, it should have. Yeah, none of the spending ones seem to have any code in them. That is my bad. All right, let me fix these right quick, and we'll be right back here. So, white, save changes. This one is red. Save changes. This one is blue. Save changes. This one.
By the way, Pyromancy, I thought you weren't botching me anymore, because there is a suspicious amount. Oh no, never mind. That's
Pokes.
That's me. All right,
so now spend your now you can spend your legend.
Poke. Okay.
Click the boom. Boom. Right.
Spend L. All
right. You can.
There we go.
You can also take a white chip now.
Take a white.
Boom.
All right.
And now you can update your sheet, and everything will be fine.
It does say that. The marshal spent 1 white, red, and blue. Or 1... Because, see, it said spend legend chip from Fletcher, and then it says marshal.
Oh, that's actually right. I spent your legend?
I didn't have a legend to spend.
No, but I'm just saying that, like...
Yeah, the output says marshal has... Yep. All right, so... welcome to... This is supposed to be a damn role-playing game. All right, so...
ain't no computers here.
You sit down, and are you attempted to collect... You're attempting to collect attention with... But not the wrong attention, right?
Right.
All right, so what sort of aptitude do you think you should be applying to this circumstance?
Presence plus charisma. No,
Do you have anything relevant to this at all?
I do. I'm just checking which one I feel would be the most...
Dice.
No. I actually think that Streetwise would work here.
I agree. So why don't you roll me main plus Streetwise?
I would, but I'm going to not roll anyway because I have a Twist of Fate.
Oh, all right. Oh. Twist of Fate. We do not know if it's going to be a crit or a botch. Odds, evens, highs, lows. Roll me a D100 and call.
I'm going to say lows.
All right.
God no. damn it.
No. No, you do not. You do all not right. say low. All right. Okay, so can you do me a favor? I need to know why Matthias draws the wrong sort of attention here. Can you show me what it is like to buy a fancy drink and try and act fancy in a dive bar? You know it's going to be good when he goes.
And this is exactly why I decided to lay low and just listen and hope to overhear people.
Excuse me, sir. Could I please yes. get your finest liquor in this establishment for myself and
do you mean the liquor that's myself. Do you mean the liquor that's very nice, the liquor that you get a fine for drinking? It's very important information.
I would like both. Give me both, please.
I regret to inform you we do not carry any sort of illegal alcohol here. All right. This is a respectable establishment. And he starts pouring two glasses. It's very respectable. That'll be $20, sir.
All right. I'll slide it across on the bar.
And you go to slide $20. Across the counter, and the bartender is reaching for the money to put his hand down on the counter, and I'm gonna need a quickness roll from everybody in the place.
Oh boy, does that include me?
Yes.
All right.
It very much does.
Is this the guy that I can or cannot botch?
You can't. We don't do unnatural dice on quickness rolls. I will specify when it comes to quickness.
So because this is just a straight quickness roll, I'll actually roll the 4d10?
Yep. All right, so do be certain that you are drawn from the action deck and not the huckster deck. When you pull your cards, you get one card plus one for every instance of five that your dice managed to hit.
What the?
If that was an action, you'd have gone bust. Unfortunately, he can't go bust on a quickness roll looking for cards, so. Pyromancy, I already explained. The finest liquor in the house and the liquor in the house that comes with a fine for drinking it.
Let's see. So I'm only going to draw.
You're going to draw two. You get one for two. Free, and then you That's get right. five. Then you get 10, 15, 20.
That's right. 20. That's right. I'll draw two cards.
Chris, what'd you get?
I got a 7.
You get a 7. All right. So you are also getting two, and then I'm taking two.
No, I would love to get through a single combat without pulling a deuce.
Did you really pull a deuce?
Yeah, of course I did.
It's not as bad as what I got. You know how I know?
Was it a black joker?
No, because I got the deuce of clubs. Which is the worst of the deuces. All right, so basically what's going to go down here is, all right, $20, please, and instead of going, what the hell, you asked for the fine slicker. And he mentioned there was a fine for drinking it. That's a lot of money. That's a lot of money. But it is the finest, and it has a fine. So clearly he is not swindling you in the slightest for any of that money. And since that is a legitimate purchase, not a single dirty mudsill in the place would consider interfering with this exchange. Which is why precisely everybody attempts to do just that. And it is a mad grab for the money. Hmm. And as absolute raw chaos breaks out, tables are flipping, chairs are flying everywhere, everybody is making a dive at the counter, right for Matthias and his money. To find out what happens next, you have to stay tuned for 3 to 5 minutes. Do not touch that dial. We'll be right back after these messages. We Welcome back to youtube.com/evilsqueegeerot, where we're playing Judas Steer, which is definitely not a game where we talk about Pukajutsu's imaginary penises during the ad breaks. Doesn't happen. There are a lot of things that do happen during the ad breaks, but I swear, we do not talk about Pukajutsu's imaginary penises in any context.
Mine, on the other hand.
No, bad. Now, we were in the middle of a scenario. As you recall, you were paying a mighty fine huge sum of money for a mighty tiny amount of alcohol that you were beginning to suspect was not actually very good alcohol. And every mudsill in the place is making a mad dash for you and your money. So, top of the cards it down. This is how we handle initiative. During your quickness roll, you were dealt a number of cards. Alright, so we go from aces. First off, I need to know if anybody pulled any jokers, red or black.
No.
All right. Aces. Kings.
Got a king.
You got a king. Which king do you have?
King of hearts.
All right. If nobody else has a king, that doesn't really matter. But if you're curious, they resolve in reverse alphabetical order. Spades, hearts, diamonds, clubs.
Okay.
All right. So, you're going to drag the king out of your hand. You're going to slap it down on the table and be like, pow.
Bam.
All right. Now.
Much like his imaginary deity.
Would you like to sleeve this card and spend it later, or spend it on an action right now? You are hidden, and thus have the advantage of stealth and surprise.
I will spend it right now.
To do?
I'm looking for a bottle.
This is a saloon. There are bottles. You may have one.
All right. Well, I'm going to grab it. That's all right. What I'm doing.
Are you cashing this bottle, yeah, or are you waiting for, are you going to find a
well,
head?
I'm trying to still remain vaguely unseen.
All right. So you're just going to quietly shatter a bottle. All right. Yeah. all right. Just so y'all know, all right, because this is theater of the mind, obviously I have no respect for rules, and therefore I will be fudging all kinds of stuff, and you are free to fudge things like actions and so on as well, all right, because that's what theater of the mind is all about. I've decided that today I am making fun of everything of theater of the mind. Who calls it that? Why do we have to sound like hipsters who are actually being passive-aggressive and angry because somebody plucked out their mustaches one handlebar hair at a time?
Did you used to have a handlebar mustache?
No. No, I did not.
That's why he's angry. He can't grow one.
I wish I could grow a handlebar. I'd be a hipster so hard, you have no idea.
I was just curious, because I was like, that was very specific. I feel like you are discussing something that has personally affected your life.
Nope. Just talking out my ass. This is technically my ass.
I was going to say this.
All right, so you grab that. All right, so kings, queens, jacks, tens, nines, eights?
Yeah, I got eight.
So do I. But mine is the last one. What is yours?
Art.
Can you put it on the table instead of being a fop?
Thank you.
you foppish dandy.
You fop. All right. So, what would you like to do with your heart? I mean, other than find somebody to love, you lonely man, you.
Well, technically, my hand's on the money.
I'm trying to snatch it back.
I am going to... In perhaps the only way that any man could possibly do this, with one hand, I'm snatching my money up.
All right.
With the other hand, I'm snatching a shot up. With my feet, I am jumping over the bar.
With my feet, I'm jumping over the... Okay. Kajair?
Yep.
Do you know what happens now?
I can't jump on camera. At least not over nothing.
But can you at least, jump? Don't be afraid to DYR your headset and step away from the chair.
No, because I can't do the I want to do the action hero side jump.
Just go get Jody and tell her to lie down. Just no.
That's no longer appropriate for Twitch terms of service.
All right. So
was that ever appropriate for Twitch?
So, all right. Can you at least pantomime like a dive? Can you dive for me?
I wish I had a. I do have a shot glass.
All right. Right. Ready?
It's a very large shot glass.
Two, one. That was actually really good. Bravo. That was very convincing. Then it's gonna be my eight. The clubs. You see, my NPCs are very concerned with this money, Matthias. It was on the counter. Now it's on you. And so, hold on, I gotta...
What the hell?
Okay. Alright, so, I'm gonna need to rewind time just a little bit here, alright? So can you make that, that dive for me, right? 3, 2, 1, go! Get him! Right, and there was this big earthquake, apparently. And then, okay, so everybody piles in over the counter. Like, it's just like lemmings. Or like those guards in SeaWorld. Not SeaWorld, is that what it's called?
No, Earthsea.
Earthsea, right. Yeah, those guards in Earthsea running off the cliff, just like, rah! Right, like, it's just chasing, diving. The whole swarm of mud seals just like diving in, and they're gonna be like beating the shit out of you with their fists and their knees and their feet.
All right.
In the process, you are going to lose 2d6 wind. So you can lose 9 wind.
All right.
That was on eights. Sevens?
I got one.
You got you a seven. Do I have a seven? Oh, no. I got a two of clubs. I'm going last. All right. So on your seven, what are you doing?
I'm going to make a grab for one of the many people that are on him and beating him.
All right.
Let me act this out a little bit.
All right.
I want to grab, like turn them around and try to smash the bottle over their head.
All right.
However,
for the record, the way you were saying that, you're like, I want to grab, turn around, and do the pook is basically what I thought was going to happen next.
Just like, hey, what's up?
It was the pause, and there was some rhythm, like, I want to grab, turn around, and then I was like, and do the creep. Like, I don't know what's happening right now.
So
you're going to grab me,
grab by the shoulder, turn up, and go for the bottle.
And
right?
Just like, boom, right in the face.
Right, but I would like to, courtesy of Pyromancy, use one of my botches.
It's not real, I would like to there.
So, Matthias, right?
Yep.
You dive over, and then all these dudes beat the shit out of you, and you kind of like, holy shit, what? And then all of a sudden you're getting yanked back over the counter, and you turn around, and there's Fletcher with a bottle. Boom, right in your face.
Oh.
Fletcher, do me a favor. Roll me your strength plus 2d6.
Oh, it's a resist. Well, can I? Oh, it's resist next. That's all right.
Well, how many resists are there?
Oh, I'm going to combine them. I got 1, 2, 3, 4. I got 5 of them. Can I make a botch out of that?
You can burn them all into a botch.
I'm going to do that.
I just need it known, Kajer, that we are at a real gaming table again because players just conspired to use the rules to punch you in the face with a glass bottle. It is a long time since I've seen party members be like, no, wait, can I use the rules there to fuck him over? Is that a thing I can do?
Yeah.
Like, natural 20! Chris goes to jail!
So, I need to roll my strength plus 2d6,
Your strength plus 2d6, yep.
Let's see what I got here. My strength is 44. Okay. So it's gonna be roll 2d6.
Exclamation point, yep. Double height mark.
Then plus 44.
Yep. Can I do that? Double height mark, yep. This was declared as to the damn face. So Matthias, that's a 19, that is 4 wounds. Wait, you're size 6, right? So it's 3 wounds to the face. Would you like to spend any chips to prevent these wounds?
Yeah, I'll spend 1 red.
All right, I draw a chip then, correct? So go ahead, spend your red, because your red goes to the pot before I pick mine up. Ooh, I got a blue. Where's my...
It's still correcting the Marshall's chips for me for some reason. Pyromancy says it's Sapo, though.
Yeah, it just means the output is saying Marshall instead of what it's supposed to say. All right, so, ball to your face, and that was to fit, so you got one wound, right? You actually did take a wound there?
Sorry, first time.
All right, so you lose three wind, because you took one wound to the noggin.
All right,
so you got, like, blood in your eye, and there's glass everywhere, and Fletcher is apologizing like he just stepped on somebody's dog.
So I get hauled back over the counter. What the?
Oh, my God. Why am I playing? I want to give that a beat.
Oh, my God. I need a clip so hard. That was funny. And then you slowly took a sip. That'll be one white chip for Matthias. You go ahead and just take a white chip out of the pot for yourself. Oh, God. All right, so Fletcher, you just... Boom! All right, so Matthias, what are you spending your seven on now? Or not your seven, whatever card that you have next, because, oh, it's a deuce, right? So it's deuces, you drop one, and then, okay, we're just going to, like true brothers, we're just dropping deuces.
You could say that you're both dropping a deuce?
Yep.
All right, so there's the only... brothers. There is only one way I can return this debt. Because they're all in the, like, behind the bar.
Yeah.
Beating the shit out of me. I will pull off my hat. I will put it on Fletcher. And I will throw him over the bar to the others.
I want to need, like, just a general fighting roll. Just to, like... not have this go horribly wrong. Give me like
twist of fate.
Oh, you got a twist. Oh my God, you got a twist of fate lined up. From who? Who did this? Whose fault is this?
Hold on. I use the botch twist of fate. Nope, never mind. This is a botch from Andreas.
All right, so Fletcher, you're like sorry. And suddenly there is a big black hat on your head, and you're like, oh shit, right? And he grabs you, and he's gonna like. Throw you over the counter, right? But in the process of throwing you over the counter, he's gonna slip and do like that, I can't keep my balance dance, and then he's gonna crash directly into the only poker table, like the only table with anybody not in the fight, right? Because they were playing poker. So there's money and chips and cards, and now there's a whole bunch of angry mud cells looking at you like right in your face, right? Like this is the view you got. Okay, because, but in order for all this to happen, we need to see it happen, right?
Yep.
Okay, so the hat goes on Matthias, or on Matthias, right? And then Fletcher goes over the bar.
He's my stunt double.
But now, Matthias, you're slip sliding. Oh, the slip into the slide. Oh no, and you're crashing into the poker table. And then you're looking up into the face of... And then it's my turn.
I'll have you know, everyone saw me keeping a hold of that drink the whole time I was flailing.
I was not expecting to turn around and see this.
I paid $20 for that drink.
I'm seeing a beat from Matthias. You can take a white chip if you can afford it.
Yeah, I can. Oh, no. I'm at my limit. No, no, you ain't. I can't do basic math. It's fine. Carry on.
All right. So it is now my turn. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to say in the chaos of like, I'm picturing one of those like Acme cartoon dust clouds, with, like stars and feet and fists kind of poking out of the sides every now and then.
Mm-hmm.
Right. This is for Fletcher. You take a whopping 3 wind. And Matthias, you're going to take 8 wind. Have I knocked you out yet?
Yes.
All right.
I don't like, I keep forgetting. I'm honestly forgetting that I can spend a chip. I think it's preventing wind and not healing wind. Because I do, like, when I get high up in wind, I intend to prevent wind. But I keep forgetting you can't prevent it. You have to heal it.
That might be my stupid ruling and not remembering the rules correctly. We'll look it up after the show, all right? And then we'll move forward with the correct ruling afterwards. All right. So... All right, so, Fletcher.
Uh-huh.
You have the hat. You know damn well why he did what he did. Over the counter you go, and there is that newly around a cry of, "Game!" And then people grabbing you, and then somebody grabs your hat, and they pull it off your head, and then he gets starting to kick crept out of him, right? And you're just like, so you weasel out of that hole scenario, and so, like, basically, you're going to be like, away from this, like, giant dust ball cloud of fists and stars and exclamation points and at symbols that don't really, never really, why did they put those in those dust clouds? Like, what was that supposed to, supposed to be cursing, I guess?
I think so. It's supposed to be curse words.
Right, but, how do you, I mean, it's not really our style. If I want to say fuck, I'm going to say fuck. But what would our censorship be if we had censorship for swears?
Swoop de whoop faces.
Quarter pound signs with cheese.
Quarter pound signs. Like, what would we do? So we'll put that one to the audience and see what they think. So, you're kind of like sneaking away from this rook. And then you turn around and there is Matthias. Just, Matthias, can you do me a favor? Can you show me what it looks like to have the crap beaten out of you while you are unconscious? 3.
Hold on. I need space for this.
All right.
Get your beats ready. Well, I guess it's like, I don't know if I should call a beat moment, but I suspect.
It's probably going to be a beat moment. Thanks, now you've made it all, like, no pressure or nothing, Frank. Right. All right, so.
Well.
All right, so there you are. You're and then all, when he turns around, you're already KO, but you are getting the absolute shit tossed out of you. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go. Chris is like, no, I'm not doing that. Like,
I realized partway through what was going on. Nearly knocked my TV over on that one.
I like the spin. That was a nice touch.
I figured it was the best way to relay a like that time when you get hit so hard you spin round. I thought that was the best way to relay that.
Dojo saw what I was going for. I was going for the beatbox.
Yeah, I was going for the shut the fuck up.
So, I won't take the white since my chips have already built up too damn high. But I will award Kajer one white if he can afford it for that beat.
I bit my lip in there.
So
it ain't really role playing until you bleed at the table.
So while it might not be a beatbox, it was a beatdown.
Yes. Fletcher, what do you do when Matthias is getting his absolute shit tossed?
I'm doing the stupidest thing I can think of.
Setting fire to the bar?
I got my bow, got an arrow.
Oh, sweet lord.
Well, in all fairness, nobody's drawn a gun, so.
All right, what are you doing with it?
I have now knocked the arrow, I've drawn the string, and I'm pointing in the general direction of people that are hovering around Matthias.
All right, and because I mean they're a little distracted, kicking the shit out of the man who really deserves it, but that's not the point.
Hey,
I don't.
Hey, I have really bad aim, and there's a lot of you. Now I don't know which one of you are feeling lucky.
I feel like you that's know, the wrong thing to say to a group of poker players.
Like you're drawing this arrow back like at Matthias, being like, I got really bad aim.
Now, if you want to back away from the man of the cloth, because he owes me money.
I'm gonna need
some bluff out of you for this.
All right.
This is the most circle jerk debt that I have ever witnessed.
All right, I got some bluff. Would that be with smarts?
It doesn't matter because you're about to botch it.
Oh god!
Oh, that's right.
Is he?
That's right. I used the resist last, so I got a botch lined up next. That's right. And then after the botch, I would get a roll. Thank you, Pyromancy, for this botched bluff. To a bar fight. I really appreciate that. It's a.
I know exactly what happens.
Great.
So
support.
I got bad aim. That priest owes me money. So if y'all feeling lucky, you best step aside, right? And one of them is gonna like everybody's gonna stop. The whole place is looking at you now, right? And they're gonna look at you. And they're gonna look and like, a couple of hands like start hovering over guns, but nobody draws. And then the big dumb lummox brute. Like, who's got shoulders bigger than his heads, and his knuckles might be dragging a little bit on the floor, right? Just fucking grabs Matthias and whips him at you through the air, and you're gonna, like, poof, and you're both gonna go slamming into the countertop. Like, I got a really bad aim, and that priest owes me money. Boosh! Like,
I'm actually disappointed, because for a botch from him, I was honestly expecting him to lose his grip on the arrow and just shoot Matthias and be like, all right then.
So that'll be 2d6 more wind that you're going to lose here.
Both of us?
No, just he's already KO'd. You're going to lose 8. Does that knock you out of wind yet? You get the wind knocked out of you?
No. I have 5 more wind.
All right. Okay. So you hit with a crack against the bar, right? And then the poker table's just gonna, like, pick up the table, put it back, start counting their chips, redeal. Like, the poker table is just, like, they don't want anything to do. Meanwhile, this whole bunch of people that have been beating the shit out of each other, stop. They look at the guy who has Matthias' hat on his head. Jim? It's not him! And everybody starts looking around. But see, here's them, right? They're here. The bar is, like, right here. And here's Matthias. So they can't see him. So they're, like, looking around.
What they're all velociraptors right now. Like,
yeehaw! They're cowboy velociraptors. Don't look at me like that! They are cowboy velociraptors. You started this!
My God, they've learned to open saloon doors.
Honest to God, at first I thought you said hee-haw, and I was like, is that a donkey velociraptor?
A velocidonkey.
What an asshole.
Alright, so, Fletcher, the wild animals of money-hungry cowpokes are looking, sniffing for the money on the air, but they can't find it. What do you do?
I am now going to make an effort to try to lug myself and Matthias out of the building.
Alright, I'm going to ask you to roll me, nimbleness plus sneaking. And by plus, I mean, roll me your nimbleness die type and your sneaking And you're sneaking number of dads.
All I can picture is like the corpse or the body just getting like slowly tugged along underneath the box.
It's like all the wreckage of all the chairs and flip tables and stuff, and like Fletcher is like from table to table trying to not be seen.
If he succeeds, the Picasso violins kick in.
Oh, 20?
That's an 8 that you got there. That'll be good enough. His highest is an 8.
8.
Don't worry about it. I always, myself, I'm always looking at it being like, what is the total? Why am I looking at the total? I don't care. Like I rolled 25. Man, that seems really high. Every roll to me is really high, and then I remember what game I'm playing.
Yeah, I looked at the total. I was like, whatever.
So you will manage to like pull his body out and lean exasperatedly against the outside wall of the saloon. Whew.
Just kind of smacking him out. You go, wake up.
And as you are doing this, you're like, wake up. There'll be another man who kind of like sneaks out the door, right? He will press himself up against the wall. And he's going to look at you and be like, what? He looks like confused. He's got himself like a white cowboy hat on, right? He looks really familiar. You can't really pin it, though. You don't know where you've seen him before. But he definitely don't look like he's from around here. And he's like pressed up against the wall. What was that? What?
Somebody couldn't hold a drink.
I held the fuck out of my drink.
I'm still trying to.
And he's still like,
I'm still trying to get you to come around.
He's like gonna look at his glass, right? And like, you don't know what he's drinking, but it's got this nice red hue to it, right? Like, it's a pretty drink. Mm-hmm. And he's gonna, I think I'm done with this. And he's gonna like hand the glass to you. And he's gonna dust himself off, pick up his backpack, and he's just gonna head on down the road.
Matthias, you awake yet?
Matthias.
Yes.
You are unconscious, right? You were asleep. Right. So go ahead and lie down. And get all right. And you are going to wake up in 3, 2, 3, because this is Matthias, 2, 1.5, go!
Where?
I hand him the drink.
Thank you.
Sputter. That tastes like copper? What in tarnation? Is that? That's blood. It's blood in this drink.
I'm checking my own mouth.
I mean, but no, you're not you. It's from the drink is this nicely mixed.
Where'd he go?
That way.
I was just like, where'd he go? He just happens to know that there was a dude who handed this to you.
Was a white hat, backpack.
White hat.
And I point in the direction I saw him walk off in.
I'm trying to remember that picture. Did he have a white hat?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I know what direction he went in, but due to the forces that conspire against me, I am certain that by the time we begin to follow his trail, he will have already gotten ahead of us, so much so that until Sam reunites with us, we will not be able to begin catching up with him.
You can take a white chip for playing out your "this is all just a role-playing game" madness. I caught that.
I take it that's the man you were looking for?
I think so.
Wow, he's right there. Man.
What an asshole.
Maybe.
It's almost like we only found him because Sam wasn't with us.
I don't follow. Nope.
Well, because if Sam were with us, he would have noticed.
There is a tradition here, Pook. When alarms or phones, or you get a ringtone on this channel, you dance to that ringtone for at least 3 seconds.
Well, I have to take this one, too.
Some with ass.
I can't explain it to him now, because now he can't hear me.
Some with ass. There you are, right?
Yeah.
And you...
Ooh. Oh, God, that hurt.
The fight is still going on inside. They have no idea what they're doing anymore.
Oh, the fight's still going on inside my head. Oh. Oh, just sweet Jesus.
And, You alright? Like, that voice comes from behind you. The other side.
Who?
It's Emmy. Emmy with her. The remnants of her green dress. She actually... No, that is her green dress. It's been fixed. She offers her hand to help you up. Nods to Fletcher.
I'm going to set the drink down because I don't enjoy drinking blood in my drinks. I'll heft myself up with her help.
And,
So he's got himself.
So Emmy just showed up on the scene.
Mm-hmm.
And is not into the whole lot of you. But her dress, when you last saw her, like, her dress was torn and shredded. Right? Like, it was... Because back then, you made your own clothes. Mm-hmm. And it was very expensive to get fancy clothes made, let alone any clothes. And you didn't have many clothes, especially if you weren't rich. Now, that's not a problem you yourself have had, but that's the normal experience of a person. And so, like, she had this dress. It was obviously her favorite and probably her only dress, and it's this brilliant, vibrant green color, and it has recently been restored and cleaned.
Where did you find somebody in the junkyard that could do that work?
I didn't.
Did you do it yourself?
Oh, heavens, no. I just paid somebody from the nice part of town that runs a tailor.
Oh, Mormons. Yeah.
Y'all seen Sam? Or the horse?
I thought she was with you.
I thought they were both with you.
She was. I stepped out from the tailor and everybody was gone. Not just Sam, not just the horse, just everybody. People were walking inside, shut the doors. Nobody talking. I mean, I just figured because, you know, well. And she's going to, like, motion to her hand. Salt Lake City is not the most, like, that part of town. They don't take kindly to people who don't look like them. And Emmy has deep, dark, ebony skin.
I say
no. Now, that sounds more like there's a problem coming into town. And I already left, so now I'm confused.
You said that. She's like, she says, she motions to the drink. She says, didn't Sally say something about that? Back in my...
Yeah.
Is he...
Yeah, he's conveniently far enough ahead of us that we can't catch up to him.
Well, then why are we waiting?
Because we need to find Sam.
And the horse.
I'm less concerned about that horse. It probably found my mentor. Good luck to them both.
Well, where do you want to find Sam? Do you think Sam'd be happy with us if we decided to find her instead of chasing down the man that never sleeps?
I mean, if I'm honest, I don't think Sam's going to be happy about anything at this moment. But... You have a point.
Tell you what, you hunt him down, I'll go find Sam. I seem to be the only one the horse will listen to anyways, sometimes. Not really. That's a lie. And she's gonna start like she starts like backing away like that you do that, that way she doesn't get mad at me for letting you not chase the yeah.
Alright.
I'll go with him, because Lord knows he can't keep himself alive.
And here's what's going to happen. The GM is going to find the actual map that he wants to use. And it's going to be all the way on the other end of the list of maps, which in fact does mean that, Alright. And so you will start tailing that man, and it just so happens that every which way you go, he's just a step ahead of you. He seems to know you're onto him. He's trying to shake you. And once or twice, you're pretty certain that he made use of some abilities that people should not have. Like walking directly past people in front of their line of sight, they're not remembering him as you ask questions. Nothing definitive, mind you, but the more, Fletcher, you help Matthias chase this man, the more you are convinced that perhaps you should start taking notes for the epitaph. This could easily be.
I'm already on it. The second I saw the look on Matthias's face when he took a sip of that drink, I started taking notes.
And the GM GM pauses to check his notes. So if y'all want to do some quick role playing.
what was so funny about that drink? I saw that look.
Just thought I'd just thought maybe I'd bit my lip or something in a scuffle. Just tasted strange, that's all.
Matthias has lied. You guys didn't hear that. It was a sound effect from a Windows alert.
That's why I was like,
what is the marshal? Because sometimes we make those noises. Like, Kajer can never be certain because sometimes his character hears things that don't exist. And sometimes I make noises that have no context that actually did happen and everyone can hear. And so he was like, what's going on? What? What's going on?
All right. Well, I don't understand how a man could walk through a crowded part of town here and nobody remember him.
Well, I've spent a lot of time sneaking past folk. And I can tell you that it can be done. You just gotta be wily.
All right. This is the map I was looking for.
But,
you apparently had like four different people thought that it was a Windows alert on their computer.
So, you're having this conversation and you're looking at Matthias like, I don't know. But,
yeah.
But he does seem a little crazy.
Yeah. Yeah. No. I think he has a very different idea of what sneaking is. Oh.
Right? And so as you start. You start leaving the town as you're tailing him, and by this point Matthias has had to resort to like actually do real tracking, which strangely he seems to be fairly skilled at. Stopping, noticing footprints or snap twigs or whatever, and it leads him into the mountainside surrounding Salt Lake City, specifically the bits and pieces that were at one point very nice, very rich, thick forests that have become littered with toxic waste from all of these new science developments that Dr. Darius Hellstrom has been installing as of late. Now, for Fletcher's benefit, since he lives here, this is a huge bit of contention among the Mormons, is that this is expanding the junkyard and ruining the countryside, God's good green earth. However, the mayor and authorities just do not care that the populace doesn't want this. And popular thought has it, it's because Darius Hellstrom pays for the whole city. It is his industry that creates any backbone upon which the economy of this place can function. So he basically gets to do whatever the damn well he pleases. And as you can see before you on the screen here, that does not always have a healthy impact on anything.
Yeah, I don't have vision, but I see it.
Yeah, we've all got black screens.
Oh, all right. One second.
But I still can't believe he gets away with this.
Matthias, you should have vision now.
Negative.
Now.
Nope.
Did I drag you? Did I not drag you onto the map? You're on the right. No, you're in the dynamic Latin layer. Do you not have control of this token?
Now I can see.
All right. As you can see here, the countryside is not faring too well under the influence of Dr. Darius Hellstrom's. Now, reports have said that it was not... that you know, reports, the news, the newspaper... well, I mean, it's not really the newspaper. It's more this publication that people take very seriously because it comes from Dr. Darius Hellstrom's laboratory. Right? They call it the peer review. And the peer review has been reporting that reports of the toxic waste side effects on the surrounding forests are greatly exaggerated. But from what you have been reading in the news here, they have been greatly under-exaggerated, probably because the reporters can't get themselves out here without being caught, hassled, dragged around, tossed out, because this is technically private property, and you are amazed that either you, Matthias, or the man that never sleeps has managed to get this far.
Are you going to put Fletcher on the map? Because I don't...
It's weird, because I don't know.
I don't see a Fletcher token.
Yeah, I don't see it either. I see the map.
It's because you technically have control over Matthias' token. Let me grab the token here.
Oh.
So as you are starting to walk in, you know, you're trying not to make too much of a trail, but like the stench of chemicals is heavy in the burning on your nostrils.
Could you imagine what this would do to a person? I can't picture it being anything good.
Yeah, probably not a whole lot of person left.
Watch your step.
Yeah, I don't real want to know what happens if it gets on your skin or boot, really.
There is this thick... You see this up here? Right here? There is a thick... heavy cobweb that goes from mound of dirt to tree stump, and you hear a twig snap behind you, and you turn, and it's Sam and the horse. Horse is technically kind of leading Sam. Emmy is trailing behind, right, and she's waving behind you, right, and then her wave suddenly stops, right? And, you turn around, because she stops, and, like, this look of horror washes over on her face. And you turn around, there is a giant mutant spider dribbling goo and green mist coming from its mandibles and every which... You don't even know where this damn thing came from. Oh, wait, no, it must have crawled up out of the water, because there's still bits of, like, swampy, gooey water, kind of like... running down its thick, furry hide. And it chitters and rears up on its hind legs and screeches a demonic screech. But to find out what happens next, you're going to have to tune in next week. Judah Steer will be live Thursday, 1 p.m. EST. Do not touch that dial. Tomorrow, 1 p.m. EST, will be live with some such something or other. I don't know yet. I'm hoping to have Diamond Academy ready. I'm hoping, but I might not have the time because I got stuff I got to tackle before then. Then Saturday, 10 a.m. EST, tune in to watch Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition. I'm Evil Squeegee, I've been your Dungeon Master today. Thank you for tuning in and watching. Kajer, Pokajutsu, you guys did wonderful. Catch Kajer on this channel whenever the damn well fuck I put him on this channel. Catch Pokajutsu over on Pokajutsu's channel over at twitch.tv/Pokajutsu. When do they find you? When?
8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern every day except for Monday and Thursdays I'm here.
What do you do?
I do Final Fantasy 14, Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild, Tales of Berseria, stuff like that. Just come on over, hang out. We have the Max Comfiness stream.
All right. Do me a favor. If you want to show your support for the show, you do not have to donate. You can follow me on Instagram. You can follow me on Twitter. You can follow me on Snapchat. You can follow me on Facebook. You can follow me on Twitch. You can like and subscribe on YouTube. Looking forward to dropping the new YouTube content. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's been a great show. Adios, amigos!